right here and then coming up like this. Because if I do that in the match, what's going to happen to me? I'm going to get blasted through, right? And so that's what you got to mentally see yourself. When I'm moving, I'm shooting, boom, coming back up, right back in my stance. So as you guys are coming down this side, I want you guys to shoot, boom, come back up in your stance. Shoot, back up in your stance. All right, let's go. Let me see. Always four. If I'm moving to the side, look at my left leg. If I'm moving to my right, my left leg is always forward. We get caught up, you know, when we come out, we shake hands, boom, we're ready to go. You know, that's when we're alert. It's that end of that second period, that third period, that's when we start to become vulnerable. Why? Because, hey, when we get tired, we'll start to be here, start moving forward. With both legs, we'll move back with both legs, or when we move to the side, we'll do like this. We'll cross our feet. And then that's when somebody, boom, times it and takes us in. So real quick, like I said, we're going to move around. You're going to circle around me. We're going to be moving in our stance. If your right leg leads, you keep your right leg forward. So when you hear me yell, go forward, look at this. Our right leg goes forward. You hear me yell, go backwards. Look at this. Go to your left. Do I cross my feet? No. All right, go to your right. Look at my, I'm in good position right here. One thing I always tell my college guys, guys, check your position. And when you hear me yell, check your position, guys. One, you should be able to touch the mat. Look at how I'm touching the mat. That lets me know I'm in good position. If I'm up here and I got, what do I have to do to touch the mat? I have to do what? Bend your knees. So what does that mean? I'm too high, right? So when I say check your position, you should be able to touch the mat without having to mess up your swag, your style. You're moving around right here. Now, if I'm up here and you hear me yell, check your position, and I can't touch, it means I got to drop it low. All right, so moving around, we're in our stance, not crossing our feet. I say move forward, check your position. Move back, check your position. Move to the left, check your position. Right, remember, am I crossing my feet? Then you're gonna hear me yell, take a shot. When you guys take a shot, reach. Remember, I'm in my stance, look at my legs. Shoulder width apart. Now when you see me dropping down to my left leg, I'm just pushing off with my right leg. Dropping, coming back up. Am I coming out of my stance? No, what can I do right here? Check my position. Good stance, good position. All right, so those are small things I want you guys to capitalize. These next couple of minutes, we're gonna spread out right here. Everybody, matter of fact, everybody, we're gonna be facing this way. Not crossing our feet, good. Forward, move forward. Move forward, good, good. Move back. Good, good. Now, take a shot, go. Come back up in your stance, moving around, go. Moving around, I'm coming around. Guys tend to fake on you. Instead of reaching out here, you gotta mentally put it in your mind. Somebody fakes, look at my level. What does it do? It lowers. I'm ready to block, I'm ready to stop these guys. Instead of getting up here and doing this, and then what's gonna happen to me? Somebody's gonna get in on my legs, somebody's gonna take me down. So that's what you wanna play with before practice, during practice, and after practice. A couple minutes a day. Good stance, visualize. Somebody faking on you, right here, moving. Boom, all right, dropping my level, right here. Because hey, I'm ready to block and do what I need to do, all right? Now, the first thing we're gonna get into, guys, how many of you guys got brothers and sisters? All right, how many of you got any fights with your brothers and sisters? We all have, right? You know, when you come in, you know, you gotta have a good setup, a good setup. You know, you have different types of setups, but my favorite setup was a simple stutter setup. You know, when you're about to fight somebody, you're like, oh, what you gonna do? And you do like this, what do they usually do? They flinch, right? That's the same mentality you gotta have with your opponents. You know, if I'm wrestling, coming out and I'm about to wrestle, so I shake hands and I'm doing this. Right here, what's my opponent gonna do? He's gonna flinch, he's gonna tense up for a second. And that's the exact moment I need right here. We're coming in with a simple inside tie. Inside tie. Everybody put your hands like this, hooks. Hooks, like a hook. Right here. Not here, yeah, here. That's what a hook is. Now, we're coming in, look at my arms, they short. Right here. Everybody, that's what it is. Not reaching out to here, because hey, if I do this to somebody, come out and reach out here, what are they gonna do to me? They're gonna shoot and they're gonna duck me. You know, next thing you know, you hear a crack go, ooh, you gonna be mad. You know? No, short arms. Now we come out, simple, studded tie. So I get this guy to freeze up. Boom, for a split second, he tenses up. Now I'm coming in. Like I said, head on the shoulder, arms in. All right? Now, like I said, guys, I'm a left leg lead. You know, a lot of you guys are right leg leads. So for right now, I'm gonna do it from a right leg lead side. Majority of you guys, I promise you, are right leg leads. I mean, how many right leg leads we have in here? You know, we got a lot of right leg leads. All right? So for right now, I'm gonna have Coach McKeever just be a right leg lead. So look, guys, small thing. Since I'm leading with the right, I'm putting my head on this side. I want you guys to see the small thing, the difference. If I put my, from me putting my head from over here, then over here. All right, when I come in and I stutter and I get Coach to tense up for a split second, I come in, short arms, hands like hooks, head to the shoulder, to the foot, boom, right here. Look at this now. I went home and tense. See, now, if I wanted to shoot on Coach right here, you see what he has to protect him right here? He has his head, right? And he can have his hand. So that's why when I come out and I shake hands, I see what leg my opponent leads. A lot of my opponents lead right leg lead, that right leg. So I'll put my head on that side. You know, if it was vice versa, if Coach was leading his left leg, I'll put my head on that side. So we'll come out, simple. Stutter, top. What touches him first, my hands or my head? All right, who says hands? So raise your hands. This is practice. Who says hands? All right. Who says head? I got to go with the head. I want you guys to see this. Why head? You know, because your defense mechanism, he has to get past your head, your hands, then your hips. So remember, head, hands, and hips, not hands. Because if he gets past my hands, I got nothing to protect me. So when I come in, stutter, pop, now I got this. Very simple. I'm in good position. Now, guys, we're taking a simple shot. Simple high crotch. Right here. So when I take my high crotch, I want you guys to see this. Guys, I'm strong up in here. Good stance, good position. Look at my back, it's straight. Now, guys, here's a good part. Well, I love turning this way, don't you? Good stance, good position. Here's a mistake a lot of us make. We'll get here, and we'll want to do this. Right here. Now, Coach was to move out of my way right now. Am I in good? Is this a good stance? No. If you come out and you shake hands and somebody's like this, what are you about to think about your opponent? You're about to eat them up, right? So when you guys are taking your shot, notice that's you right here. Now, when I step up, I want you guys to see this. Got my back strong, head up. Now look how when I step up. Now I want you guys to see if Coach was to move out of my stance now. Is this good stance? Good position? Yeah. Look how I got my shoulders up on it. I'm ready to explode and go through there. You guys see what I'm saying? Why everything relates back to your stance and position. So I come out, stutter, tie. Now I take my shot. Boom. Right here. Now I want you guys to see this. When I step up, remember, what am I in? Stance. So we're going to step up and drive. As I drive, I'm reaching to my double leg. Not up here, high, to the back of his knee. Right here. Now, running across. Right here. Now, I want you to see who hit the mat first. He did. I didn't hit the mat, he did. Now I'm on top of him. How many points did I just get?
Two.
Two. So we're gonna come out, we're gonna do it in steps real quick. You gonna hear me say, check your position. We're in good stance. Right here. Now you're gonna hear me say step one. Step one, simple, stutter tie. Stutter, tie. Now, remember, how are my hands like what? Hooks. And look, guys, look where they're at the back of his armpits. Not here, back of his armpits. Now, got good position. Step two, take your shot. You shoot, strong back. Is my head down? Am I like this? No, I'm up, strong back. Now, step three. When you step up, you reach across. Notice, guys, look how I reach across, and I run my feet. Step across. When I step up, I reach across. Right here. Boom.
Land on top of.
Now, Getting our single leg, driving up. Guys, I want you to understand, when you guys are hitting that single leg and you're driving up, that's your rest position. You can rest right here. You ask my college guys. I tell these guys, shoot, get up, and rest. I can catch my breath right here. Because, hey, you ask coach, he feels uncomfortable. He's not comfortable here. You see what I'm saying? Here, if I rest down here, he'll flatten me out if I rest there. You guys see what I'm saying? So that's why, you know, I don't like you shooting. Just stand right there like you're shooting and driving up to your feet. All right? So once again, we come out, stutter tie. Now, I got to move that guy. So I circle and move him right here. Remember, I'm like a what? I got to think like a what? Shotgun. Now I'm ready to explode. Drive up to here. Right here. Now, I want you guys to see this thing right here. You look at coach. He has a straight leg. So that means he's flexible. He's comfortable. All right? Now, when you guys are in your stance, I want you to give him a little shoulder lean. I want you guys to see this. I got my hands locked. They're locked above his knee. You ask coach, when I put my shoulder into him, you see that? I want you guys to see it. At first, his leg was straight right here. He can jump around, move around. But once I give him that little shoulder lean, you ask him, you look at that knee now. What does it do?
Bench.
It bent. Now, that makes it easy for me to finish. Right here. All right? How many of you guys try to get here, and then you try to finish, but you put your chest on, and then this guy just stays on his feet and try to do this and do that? How many of you guys have tried to do that? I'm sure it's all right, raise your hand. We all have. We try to put our chest on, we try to sit that guy. You guys like, are you serious? You're not gonna sit me. That's the difference right there. When you get that leg right here, look how I'm locked above the knee. I want you guys to see this. And I give him that shoulder lean right here. Now, what is coach telling me right now? He wants to be what? He wants to sit down, right? He's like, man, hurry up and sit me. Now, that's when our first takedown comes. Little step, big step. I want you guys to see this. We took our shot, we came up. What am I in right here? Now, look how I got my hands locked. Now, I put my shoulder right here on his thigh. I just squeeze it. Now that sends the message, he's like this. You know, he's like, okay, hurry up and sit me. Alright, now I got all that weight on that leg. So we're right here. Now the only thing we're gonna do, guys, is a little step. I'm going a little step forward. I'm gonna do it on the line right here. So you guys can see this. I'm gonna be a little step, and I'm a big step. Alright, so a little step forward, and then look, watch this. Look at my leg. Big step. All the way around. You guys see that? So I'm here, I'm a little step forward. Then I'm a big step all the way around. Boom. Sit that guy to his butt. Guys, did I drop to my knees? No, because a lot of times you get those flexible guys, you try to little step forward, and then you try to drop to your knees, and then you got those athletic guys, flexible guys, they're like, oh, thank you. You just helped me. And then they step over, they stop you, they cradle you, and smash you down. So once again, we got our starter tie right here. We circle and pull them, take our shot, drive up. Now, our first finish. Remember, what's my sign to let me know this guy is ready to be seated?
Knee.
How do I bend his knee?
Shoulder.
Give him a little shoulder. Right here. Heads up. He feels that. Now, I got a little step forward. Look at this. I'm just going a little step forward. A little step forward. Then I'm a big step all the way around and sit that guy to his rear. Right here. Now, guys, look. Is this guy usually just going to stay here? What's he going to do? He's going to turn. And what do I have to do?
Okay.
Break him down here. You got it tight. You got this tight up here. This is your baby. You ain't letting this go. Like I said, this is my reward. This is how I'm going to get my two. But if I'm like this, or hey, if I'm locked like this. If I'm locked like this, he's not going to feel any pressure. He can kick out and do what he needs to do. All right? So look at my arms. They're short and tight right here. Now, that's when I slow my prey down. This is my victim, like, all right, now, you ain't going nowhere. Got my head up. Now, guys, look, when you guys are practicing this at home, like I said, I'm right here, I can stay on the line right here. I can little step forward, and then I'll little step all the way around. Look how I stay on the line. You guys see that? How I stay on the line. Now I drop down and get my tip. Alright? So you guys can, when you guys are at home, you're like, okay, go step forward, and then I'll big step all the way around. Look how I'm still on the line. That lets you know you're doing your steps right. Alright? Very simple. Very easy. Alright? Next thing, we get our single leg. Now, say you got those guys that are flexing. I'm trying to sit them down. They got the athletic ability. They're not falling down or nothing like that. Now, guys, we got our single leg. We're right here. We're trying to sit them. Ah, he stand up. I can't, you know, I can't do this and be like, hey, coach, he ain't cooperating. You know, this ain't what I work on. He's supposed to sit down. I saw his knees bent. No, you got to be ready to switch to your next deal. So he's not giving me, I'm trying to sit him. Ah, I can't get it. I can't get it. My head's up. I'm in good position. Now, guys, here's what our next deal we're gonna go to. Got this tuck. Guys, we're gonna step behind the leg. Right here, look at my hip, look at my, so I'm by myself, I'm right here. I'm gonna act like, step behind the leg. Now, what does this guy have to do?
Trip.
He's gonna trip or he's gonna jump over. So as I step behind the leg, right there, make him step over it, look at my heel, it's up. Now, I'm sliding. My hands going to the thigh, I'm sliding down to the ankle, right here. Getting to right here. Everybody show me the Pledge of Allegiance. How do we do the Pledge of Allegiance? Gotta be chest proud for our country, right? All right, here's the thing. The reason why I say that, guys, that's where you wanna be, chest proud. You watch the soldiers, they're chest proud, Pledge of Allegiance, right? They're like this. But hey, a lot of the times when we get in these matches, we ain't as proud as our country. We get to putting our hands right here. We're all victims of that. And we grab the leg and we're right here. So always think, when you get here, you step behind the leg, make him trip, or make him jump, slide. Pledge of Allegiance, I'm chest proud. I'm not even waiting for somebody like, yeah, coach, I'm about to get this. All right, this is all I want, chest proud. So I want you guys to see the difference. I'm trying to sit this guy, he's not falling. Boom, boom, now I want you guys. Hey, number two guy, just jump over it, don't fall. All right, so as I step behind and make him trip, look, guys, I slide down to the ankle. I want you guys to see. I slide down to the ankle. Right here. Bring it up here. You guys see that? Now, what is my hand supposed to be what? Like the what? I want you guys to see the difference. If I'm like this, look how coach is. He's comfortable. Right here. But when I'm at the, when I'm back here and I go chest proud, you ask him. He feels that. Look at his leg. It's in the feet. Here, he's comfortable. He can jump, do what he does, hand fight with me and do it. But right here, he's like, okay, hurry up. You guys seeing the small things? That's what we want. Remember the first one, what was our signal? Here, right? Got that knee bend. Now, I can't get that, so I'm going to step behind and trip. Boom. Now I'm here. Now, Pledge of Allegiance. Now I got that leg to what? Bend again. This is what makes it easy, guys. What makes it real easy. So for right now, here's what I want. Real quick, we're gonna try to sit the guy. He's not going. Now we step behind it, boom. Slide it up to here. Pledge of Allegiance, chest proud. Get this guy moving. And we're gonna bring it right in. We're gonna hit our finish, very simple. Any questions? So I gotta get this guy close to me. So that's why I say, you can use two hands if you want. I don't have a problem with it. Just make sure you lean back. Now you got this guy close to you. Now, guys, I want you to see why I got this guy close. Why? Because it's easy now for me to underhook. Now I can underhook this guy. Now here's the mistake we all want to make right here when we underhook. We'll get here and we want to trip forward right here. No, guys, that's how a guy can scramble with us, catch our legs, and wrestle with us. No, look, when we get him here, we got him leaned up, I got him underhooked. Now look how I got him bouncing. Bouncing, bouncing, bouncing. Now that's when you time to jump. That's when you time your jump. So when I got coach here, boom, I got him here, I underhooked and got him. Now look. Now, what's the crowd doing? Ooh, and then what are we doing?
Yeah.
Make the crowd go, ooh. That's how it is. That's how you want to time it. Guys, when we got this leg here, got the leg here, we don't want to try to trip like that. No, we're here timing, bouncing, bouncing. Look at my motion, guys. Look at this. Kick this leg up, and then what did I do? I came down with him, right? I didn't kick him up. And then, no, because hey, he landed wrong. Next thing you know, depending where you're at, Ref can be like, I'm beating this dude by 14 points. I kick his leg out from him to get my last takedown. He lands wrong. He starts screaming. He can't go no more. Whose hand's going to get raised? He's like, I can't go no more, but I'm going to get my hand raised. You know, next thing you know, he's like, so when you guys kick the leg up, come down with the guy. Because why? Now you're here. This guy ain't just going to land on his back. What's he going to do? He's going to scramble. He's going to roll. So you got to be down ready to catch that guy. If I get coach here and I'm leaning back and I trip him like this, boom, and I do this, see, he can come up, kick, scramble, get out. How many points did I get there? Zero. And who did all the work? Yeah. And next thing you know, I'm like, tired, frustrated, mad. He's like, I won't let that happen, man. Now he's energized, ready to go. So once again, when we get this, lean back, pledge of allegiance, underhook him. Now I'm tripping to his back. Boom, come down. Now we're ready to do what we got to do. You guys see that? So once again, we got our studded tie. Boom, move the guy. Take my shot. Now I'm trying to sit the guy. He won't sit down. I'm trying to sit him. Now I step. Boom. Got it here. Now I'm leaning back. Got him close to me. Now I can under. Now I can time. Guys, look. I'm short. So I always have been bringing guys in. So you can either do it one of two ways. You can either underhook or lean back. And you can punch up directly up under that leg. Whatever you feel comfortable doing. Alright, so but the key thing is you gotta get him moving. You can't just sit here and try to trip a guy. It's not gonna work. You see what I'm saying? Get him bouncing, get him jumping. Then you time it. Boom, kick it, bring him down. Very simple. Very easy. Be careful. We got alright, so which is gonna be our last thing on our feet. Alright, we're gonna come in, get our simple inside tie. Now say he doesn't cooperate and he fights inside tie. It's okay. We just take the simple outside tie, grab his elbows, right here. I want you guys to see this. When I got my simple inside tie, right here, studded tie, he fights inside. Guys, look at this. I'm sliding, grabbing his elbows, and I'm pulling him in right here. Now, I want you guys to see this. You ask coach, does he feel comfortable right here?
No.
No, he doesn't feel comfortable. So, I promise you, 99% of the time, guys don't feel comfortable there. What are they gonna do? They're gonna thumb block, and they're gonna try to what? Create what?
Space.
And I want you guys to see, when guys are trying to create space, look at their arms. Now look what it sets them up for. A post, all right? Now, but the deal is though, guys, look, we got inside tie. He didn't give us the inside, so we grabbed his elbow. And look how we're walking forward. Remember, if I'm a right leg lead, what leg always goes forward?
Right.
I do not wanna see you guys doing this. Because, hey, he might not cooperate with you. He can be like, hey, let me get one more push until I get my right leg forward so I can take this shot on you. No, you got to be ready at all times. So you're right here. You're walking in like this. Now when he fights, now look at this, guys. I'm ready to step and post this guy through. So I got my simple inside tie right here. He fights. Now I pull him. Now he fights to get up out of there. He's still. Now, look, guys, this is what I want right here. Got this guy extended. Now here's the key thing, guys. I want you guys to see the small thing. Guys, a lot of guys try to do this post. And then next thing you know, this guy brings his elbows back in, and then I try to shoot and he catches me. Guys, when you guys post right here, you guys are straightened out, you post above the elbows. Where do I post?
Above
the elbows. Now I want you to see, your hands are like hooks. It ain't just posting and then dropping. No, guys, it's posting. You guys see that? Look how I pull that guy up on me. Boom. Right here. Now, guys, just like our high crouch. Very simple. Right here. Warrior to the double. Now, guys, do I stay in front of him or I get to the side and finish?
Side.
Get to the side and finish. Right here. Land on top of the guy. Very simple. So here's what I want. Simple. Start and tie. He fights inside, grab his elbows, walk him forward. He fights to get up out of there, make him fight. Close. Dry. Very simple. Very easy. Didn't mess up your swag at all. All right? So always walk forward, pushing. Today, if I'm pushing him this way, he's going to push and try to get out, make him extend, then you move him forward. Do your thing. Finish. Any questions?
Up under this guy right here. And then what happens?
Yes. Shot.
And then we were like, I can't get out.
Guys, remember, just like a stand-up, when I hit my stand-up, how many arms, I want you guys to see how many arms Coach was holding me with when I stand up. I hit here. How many arms is he holding me with?
One.
Nah, he's holding you with one rep. You see what I'm saying? And I got a rule. No dude should ever hold you down with one arm. You're too strong. You're too good. All right? So once again, when I hit a switch, notice, when I clear my arm right here, how many arms is he holding me with?
One.
Now, guys, this is the most important step right here.